Welcome to my second lesson on trigonometry. Have you, like many lost souls, spent your life searching for an identity? Well, search no longer, because here's one that will change your life for the better. Okay, I'll be serious. In this lesson, we will derive the most well-known trig identity. Sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. It is called an identity because it is true for all values of theta. Let's review the definitions of sine and cosine. I'm going to omit saying the angles, okay? Instead of saying sine theta, I'll just say sine. So we get sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. Next, I want you all to picture in your mind a hypotenuse of 1 unit. Wow, look what happens when we substitute 1 for the hypotenuse. We find that sine is equal to its opposite side, and cosine is the same as its adjacent side. This results in a very special triangle that will have many uses for us later on. Here's a summary of what just happened. Now we see a special right triangle whose hypotenuse is 1, the opposite side becomes sine theta, and the adjacent side becomes cosine of theta. I bet you see the trig identity already. That's right. Applying the Pythagorean theorem, we obtain the most useful trig identity ever. It is sine squared plus cosine squared equals to 1. Don't forget to write in the angle, even though I'm not reading it, okay? Sine and cosine is always of something, all right? But when you read it, it makes it a lot easier if you don't read the angle. We have to be extremely familiar with all its forms. We have sine squared plus cosine squared is 1. Switch the terms. We have cosine squared plus sine squared is 1. Sine squared is 1 minus cosine squared. Cosine squared is 1 minus sine squared. And guess what? We should even recognize it when it's upside down. Here's a chart from lesson 1 that I suggested that you memorize. We'll use the values in it to solve an example. Here's the example. Verify that the angles 30 degrees and 45 degrees satisfy this trig identity. Let's do the 30 degree one first. We have sine squared of 30 degrees plus cosine squared of 30 degrees equals sine of 30 degrees is 1/2. Cosine of 30 degrees is square root of 3 over 2. Square those out, we have 1/4 plus 3/4, and that adds up to 1. Next, let's try the 45 degree angle. Sine squared of 45 degrees plus cosine squared of 45 degrees equals sine of 45 degrees equals 1 over square root 2. So does cosine of 45 degrees. That equals 1 over square root 2. Square those out, we get 1/2 plus 1/2, and there's our 1. Okay, hope you enjoyed learning this trig identity. In the next lesson, we will derive another useful trig identity. See you next time.